Imagine a world where mobile phones didn't fit in your pocket, where communicating from a car was a symbol of power and ultimate luxury. In 1983, Nokia broke the barriers of the impossible with the Actionman I, a phone that cost 8 times more than an iPhone and revolutionized the way we connect, but at a price only a select few could afford. Today, I'll take you back to the early days of mobile technology to explore how this device changed history. What made it so special? Why was it so expensive? And what lessons does it leave us today in a world saturated with technology at everyone's fingertips? Stay with me, because the story of the Nokia Actionman I isn't just fascinating, it's the origin of the mobile world we know today. To understand the impact of the Nokia Actionman I, we must go back a little further to 1982, when Nokia and its Mobira division launched the Mobira Senator, a 10-kilogram giant designed exclusively for cars. Though rudimentary, the Senator represented the first step toward mobile communications, enabling calls on the go using the NMT450 analog network. A year later, in 1983, the Actionman I perfected this idea, taking mobile communication in cars to a completely new level. And in 1984, Motorola turned this evolution on its head with the Dynatac 8000X, the first commercially available portable phone. Each of these devices was key in shaping mobile telecommunications as we know them today. Now, let me tell you a true story that very few people know. It was just another day, April 3rd, 1973, but Martin Cooper was about to make history. Walking the streets of New York with a device that looked like something straight out of a science fiction movie, the prototype of the Motorola Dynatac 8000X, Cooper dialed a number. On the other end of the line was Joel, his direct competitor at AT&T. With courage, Cooper said,
"Joel, I'm calling you from a mobile phone. Yes, a real mobile phone that you can carry with you anywhere."
That brief conversation, made from a brick weighing almost a kilogram, not only marked the first mobile phone call in history, but also the beginning of a technological revolution that would forever change how we communicate. It was more than just a call. It was a moment that connected the world to the future. The Mobira Senator. The beast that started it all. The Mobira Senator was revolutionary for its time, although far from what we consider a mobile phone today. Weighing 10 kilograms, this phone was designed exclusively for installation in cars, relying directly on the car battery for power. Through the NMT450 network, it offered something unprecedented, the ability to communicate on the move. However, its size and design reserved it for business people and politicians who could afford this luxury. Despite its limitations, the Senator proved that mobile communication was possible, laying the foundation for what was to come. For this reason, the legendary Nokia Actionman I, which I have right here, is recognized as the second portable phone in history. Its innovative design and ability to bring communication into vehicles marked a turning point in the evolution of telecommunications. In 1983, having a Nokia Actionman I installed in your car didn't just mean keeping up with technology. It also showed that you belonged to an elite class capable of accessing a luxury few could imagine. This device represented a monumental advance in how people communicated, enabling conversations on the move for the very first time. The NMT450 network on which this model operated was a marvel of its time. Specifically designed for Nordic countries, this technology marked the beginning of unprecedented connectivity. What's most surprising is that this phone didn't have the features we are accustomed to today. There were no text messages, apps, or cameras. Its monochromatic screen displayed only the essentials, the number you dialed and the signal strength. Yet that was enough to make it an icon of the future, the high cost of the Actionman I wasn't just due to its advanced technology, but also the status it conferred. This was a phone that shouted, "I have power, I have influence, and I'm one step ahead of the rest of the world." Politicians, business people, and high-profile figures used it not only as a communication tool, but as a declaration of prestige. A phone with its own engine, the story of the Nokia Actionman I with its 100 selectable channels via the numeric keypad, this device offered something never seen before. The ability to communicate while on the move. Something reserved exclusively for the wealthiest. The Motorola Dynatac 8000X, the first commercial portable phone. While Nokia dominated the car phone market, Motorola took a leap into portability with the launch of the Dynatac 8000X in 1984. Known as the brick phone because of its size and shape, it was the first commercially available portable mobile phone. It weighed 800 grams, measured 33 centimeters tall, and offered 30 minutes of talk time with a 10-hour charge. Although its functionality was basic and its price steep, $4,000 at the time, the Dynatac symbolized the beginning of personal mobility, breaking the limitations of phones tied to vehicles. It was the first step toward a future where mobile phones would become an extension of ourselves. The evolution of mobile phones during this time was extraordinary. The Mobira Senator marked the beginning, proving that mobile communication in vehicles was possible. The Nokia Actionman. I refined this concept, reducing its weight by 7 kilograms and taking it to a superior level by offering more practical and advanced connectivity for its time. Finally, the Motorola Dynatac shattered all barriers, taking mobile telephony out of cars and bringing it to the public as a personal device. The Actionman I was heavy, exclusive, and limited. But in its time, it was the gateway to a world where mobility was no longer a luxury, but a necessity. Its story reminds us that even with rudimentary tools, human ingenuity can change the course of history. I'm Leonardo, and this has been today's story. If you enjoyed it, don't forget to leave a like, share it, and subscribe. See you in the next video. Best regards.